It's great to be back down here. You know, the Sergeant Major Academy is a very important event for the Army. This is the cornerstone of how we develop our non-commissioned officer senior leadership who will continue to lead us. So it was very important for me to come down here to participate in that. But while I was here, I also had the opportunity to spend a lot of time with over at the 1st Armored Division, talking about current operations, talking about their training, talking about what their plans are for the future. Also talking to, had the opportunity to talk with brigade commanders and brigade sergeant majors and some company commanders and first sergeants. So it's been a wonderful visit here. It's always great to come back and get in touch with the great work that's going on in our Army. And everywhere I go, I'm incredibly proud of our soldiers and our leaders and the support that I get from the local communities. The close relationship with El Paso to Fort Bliss has been long-standing, but every time I come down here, it seems to be stronger and stronger. We appreciate that very much, the great support of the great people here in El Paso. We can't operate without having the complete trust between every soldier in the Army. So this is our number one priority. There's several things that we're doing. I held a 2- and 3-star meeting about 2 weeks ago, along with Sergeant Majors up in Washington. We spent 2 days talking about the way ahead. And I talked about my priorities. One is to make sure that we are first caring for the victims, that we take every allegation seriously, that we will investigate every allegation, we will protect the victims. But that's the first step. The second step is then to ensure that we start to change the climate within our Army, where this is not tolerated, and that those who tolerate it will be punished, and frankly, will no longer be part of our Army.
Yeah, you know, our Army's foundation is built on trust, and this is about making sure that we have trust, you know, from the most junior soldier to the most senior officer in our Army. And it's an Army problem. It's not a female issue, it's not a male issue, it is an Army issue. And it's my firm conviction that as an Army, we identify a problem, we will solve that problem. And we'll start with our NCO Corps, based off the guidance from our officers, and we will be successful.
And a lot of people will ask, you know, why now? You've said you've been fixing this for a period of time. It hasn't been fixed, so what's different now? Well, what's different now is we are going to ensure we have the focus and attention of every leader, of every soldier on this problem. We have crossed the line. We can no longer stand for having an Army that tolerates sexual assault, sexual harassment. We're going after it, and that's what's changed.